Some of you, the lucky few of you, have been lucky enough to experience lucid dreams. A dream where you're conscious of the fact that you are dreaming and might actually be able to exercise some agency over what goes on in the dream. Well, up until now, you might have been lucky enough to just do it, or perhaps you could be trained to learn how to do it, but now we've got another technique. Scientists have learned in a report that's being, it's gonna be published soon in Nature Neuroscience, that by applying electrical current to people's brains as they sleep, you can induce lucid dreaming. Let's give you some information about the research study they did. The research involved 24 volunteers with no prior history of lucid dreaming. The subjects went to sleep and eventually dreamed. Then researchers turned on a 30-second long electrical signal and then woke them up and asked them about their experiences. It turned out that a 40 hertz stimulation induced lucid dreams 77% of the time. Now, this did not require any sort of permanent implantation of the electrodes into the brain. They were just temporarily attached to the scalp, and very small amounts of electricity were fed into their brains as they slept, and yet there was a very high success rate in terms of getting them to lucid dream.
Did they remember the dreams throughout, or they remembered them when they woke up because of some stimulation that happened afterward?
There is a lot of debate about what lucid dreaming actually is and whether it is anything. Right. The idea that of people who believe in it is that you are conscious. Some part of your brain that is normally turned off during dreaming is instead still active, and you can acknowledge that you are in a dream and thus be able to do something. But opponents of that position say that no, you just had a dream that you were aware of dreaming, and it's nothing new, it's nothing different.
Yeah. It sounds really dangerous, though, because I was reading it, and the side effects, like you can have seizures and stuff like that from the electrical
shocks. Oh, really?
Yeah. Ooh. It's like, I don't know, it just seems like a weird thing. I understand why they want to progress and like find out more about lucid dreaming, but at the same time, it's like if you just want to have like crazy dreams, just like smoke pot before you go to bed or something.
Oh, does that
like,
work?
Don't provide like electrical currents to your brain.
Yeah.
Just do it a healthier way.
And what if you get stuck in the dream and the dreidel never stops spinning?
Exactly.
Did they think about that?
Or if you fall asleep in your dream and then time is 10 times slower, you might be gone for centuries.
Okay, but you know, I used to have this phenomenon when I was a kid. Like, I towards the morning, I would recognize that I was in a dream, but I'm still mainly sleeping, and then I'd be like, yes, have sex with everyone. Okay? Seriously, am I the only one who thought that?
That is the end goal of every lucid dream that has ever existed.
Exactly. Like, I'm like, oh, I'm in a dream. Oh, go house, right? And so then I would like tell myself to have sex with all the girls that were in the dream, and then but then it became kind of pointless, because I was like, come on, who am I kidding? Because this isn't really a dream, because I'm kind of conscious.
Agree to disagree.
Do you see? So I was still kind of sleeping, but once you slipped into at least semi-consciousness, I feel like it doesn't count.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then you're just imagining stuff.
Right,
having like fantasies in your head.
I would say, given the choice, I would rather really dream about having sex with these people rather than wake up and figuratively dream about having sex with these people.
Totally.
So really, really fast, a little bit more information about what they actually did, because many people would say, well, yeah, you woke them up and they said they had a lucid dream, but they're in there for a sleep study. They're being prompted to do it. They were a little bit more savvy about their methodology than that. The electrical stimulation that we talked about earlier was gentle enough that people could not actually feel it, and some people were in a control group that had electrodes on their scalp, but they were never turned on. Also, the study was double-blind, as all proper scientific studies should be. Neither the volunteers nor the people who interviewed them were told who had what kind of stimulation. And they were able to look at like activity in the brain, and they believed that what they were doing was simply activating the same sorts of activity in the brain that happened during natural lucid dreaming.
So did all the guys have sex with everyone in their dreams?
I don't know that they gave details about it.
Whatever happened to like wanting to fly in your dreams?
Oh, yeah. Really?
Fly to wherever the girl is to then have sex with her.
Yeah, no, that's the difference, because that's because you're a woman. So like in your dream, you do fun things like flying.
I mean,
whereas guys are like, women, locate the women. Where are they? Must go get them right now. This is a rare moment of lucid dreaming. Go.
This isn't just because dreaming is one of the most fundamental parts of humanity that we have almost no knowledge of or understanding of. It also can be used to treat people with chronic nightmares and things like that. And I have to imagine that if they can commercialize this in some way, that would make a pretty awesome product. I think many people would want to use that.
Oh, yeah, sure. You go house with that. But I still feel like it's cheating. No, I don't mean on your girlfriend or wife. I mean, like, that's not really a dream. You're cheating, right?
What about virtual reality when they finally come out with virtual reality realistic enough to simulate sex?
That I'm totally in favor of, because that's not cheating.
Okay.
Okay. Okay, I know it makes no sense. Jesus, you could fly in real life, so whichever like fantasy you would like, you could fly or have sex with the 10 hottest women you know with no repercussions. Go.
Could I have sex flying?
Ooh. See, I would do that.
Boom.
No, you're not allowed to fly. Which one is it?
The sex.
Of course it is. The only one who might, you know, ridiculously say flying is JR. All right, I'm curious. Which one, JR?
Lucid dreams? Mm-hmm. The thing is, I've flown in my dreams before, so I'll take the sex. I've experienced the flying. It's okay.
Oh, okay.